There have been 862 episodes of Doctor Who broadcast to date. My mission? For every single one, say something nice. Hello dear viewers and welcome back to another episode of Say Something Nice. We're jumping forward almost 30 years, but sticking with a Scottish Doctor in The Empress of Mars. The Empress of Mars got 5.02 million viewers, and of course Peter Capaldi is the Doctor here, with Pearl Mackie as Bill and Matt Lucas as Nardole. I absolutely love Ice Warriors, but unfortunately I don't actually have much green in my wardrobe. I've got a nice green button-down shirt, but that needs ironing, and I didn't iron it today, so, but look, I've got green Mario. That counts, doesn't it? They are one of my favourite monsters, and I really loved when the new series brought them back in Cold War, but I really enjoy seeing them on Mars in this story. And I love the design of the Empress. I think she is so well played, and the bit where she wants to talk to Bill, because yeah, all of the men have been running around shooting at things, and Bill and the Doctor are the only people sort of without guns. And she wants to talk to Bill. Okay, what should we do here? And I think that's a really noteworthy moment. And it's a great way to get the companion involved. And it ties back in with Cold War as well, when the Doctor thinks the best person to send in to talk to Skaldek is Clara. And that story makes it clear that the women of Mars and the women of the Ice Warrior culture are just as important as the men. And that here is juxtaposed to the Victorian kind of soldier mentality of, you know, that's man's work and women don't get involved in this. But the moment I really am picking out here, there's so much to enjoy about the story, but the moment I'm picking out here is we get Alpha Centauri. Alpha Centauri from The Curse of Peladon, the original giant green phallus in a cloak, is back. And it's the original prop being shot on screen, I believe. And it's the original voice. It's Yasan Churchman back as Alpha Centauri welcoming the Ice Warriors to the Galactic Federation. It's such a nice touch. And of course, Mark Gatiss is a fan going back to the 1970s. But generally in his scripts, unless he is bringing back an old monster, he has a very light touch of putting in old continuity. Even back in The Unquiet Dead, he was going to put in sort of a rerun of the scene from Pyramids of Mars, where the Doctor and Rose go back to the TARDIS and the Doctor shows Rose a different future, but he couldn't make it work in the script, so he dropped it. He's not someone who just puts in fan references for the hell of it. So to put in Alpha Centauri here, it doesn't take anything away from viewers who've never seen the Peladon stories, but my heart leapt with joy, and I think it's such a deft move on the part of Mark Gatiss, who's writing, say, in the Russell T Davies era, I always thought was, you know, really, this is competent, this is fine, but as I've gotten older and revisited his stories, I see they've got a lot of depth and subtlety. And this is a story with depth and subtlety, but then just hits you over the head with Alpha Centauri at the end, but it's perfectly balanced, and I absolutely love it. I just love seeing Alpha Centauri again. Absolutely brilliant. I gather sort of from people talking online, Empress of Mars isn't regarded as a hugely great story, and I think it's really good. I mean, it comes just before the best Cybermen story in existence to date, in my opinion. Possibly more on this in the next episode. But I think it's a lovely 45-minute story just on its own. And the reappearance of Alpha Centauri is something really nice about the Empress of Mars. As always, thank you all so much for watching. If you would like to see this channel grow, please like, share, subscribe. It all helps more people see this face and these shirts. However, whatever you choose to do, enjoy the rest of your day, please take care of yourself, and I will see you in the next video.